Hello students, today we are going to start the class 7 computer science, and the very first chapter of your computer science is computer a machine. In this chapter we will going to discuss about the computer's fundamental. Okay, now in your previous classes, as you know, you have already learned about what is computer. You all are aware of the definition of the computer, but still I am going to tell you the definition of the computer. A computer is an electronic device that operates according to the instruction stored in its memory, or in simple terms you can also say that a computer is a machine which makes your work easier. Here is it is a image of a computer. Here it is a monitor, CPU, speaker, keyboard and a mouse. Now computer is made up of two parts, hardware and software. Now let's start with the hardware. Hardware is the physical device which can be seen and touched. Okay. And your computer is divide has the four types of devices. First one is input devices, second one is output device, processing devices and storage device. Let's start with an input device. Here you can see the some of the input and output devices. An input device sends data and instruction into the computer, but and without any input device a computer would be only a display unit, like your TV without a remote control. Okay, here are some of the input devices you should be aware of. First one is digital camera, and I know all of you will be aware of the digital camera. You have many times you have taken this pictures from the digital cameras. It is an input device that takes picture digitally and the images are stored as a data on a memory card. The next one is scanner. Scanner is an input device that reads an image and converts it into a digital file. A scanner is connected to a computer through a USB. Which makes electronic copy of the picture or a document. It is used for direct data entry from a source document into a computer system. It converts the image of document into a digital form so that it can be fed into the computer. This capturing of information reduces the possibilities of error typically experienced during the large data entry. Here are some of the scanners, types of scanners. First one is flatbed scanner. It is used on a flat surface to scan a document. It consists of a flat surface on which you can put document to be scanned. The next one is seat fed scanner. Seat fed scanner are similar to flatbed scanner. They allow the user to scan multiple pages at a time. The paper is moved automatically through the scanner across a stationary scan head. Here you can see the images of flatbed scanner and the seat fed scanner. Now the third one is handheld scanner. These type of scanners are used through the hand movement. These scanners are mostly used in shopping stores. And the last one is drum scanner. It is used to capture the highest resolution from an image. These scanners are mostly used in shopping stores. Now comes to the processing device, also known as the brain of the computer. And here I have given you the block diagram of the computer, which is very, very important for you all. So in your processing device, is divided into three components, namely the arithmetic logic unit, known as ALU, memory unit, MU, and the control unit. Now comes the ALU, arithmetic logic unit. It performs all the arithmetical calculations like additions, subtractions, multiplications, divisions, and logical operations such as add, and, or, greater than, less than, etc. Now comes the control unit. Control unit is one of the most important part of microprocessor. Basically, the circuit inside the CPU. It controls all the operation inside the CPU. The functions control unit perform can be depend on the type of CPU you are using. The last one is memory unit. Memory unit is like a storeroom of the computer. All the data and instructions are stored temporarily or permanently into the computer. Now comes to the output devices. An output device is any piece of computer hardware equipment which converts information into human readable form. These devices are selected on the basis of their cost and speed, as well as form in which output is required. Here are some of the output devices which we are using in our in our daily basis. First one is plotter. A plotter is a special kind of output device that, like a printer, produces images on a paper but does so in a different way. Here is the picture of a plotter. It is known as a drum plotter. Drum plotter draws on a paper wrapped around a drum, which turns up to produce one image on a plot. Now the next one is flatbed plotter. Flatbed plotter draws on a paper placed on a flat surface. And the last one is inkjet plotter. And in inkjet plotter, an image can be created by spraying a small drop of ink on a paper. Now comes to the storage device. A storage device is a piece of computer hardware used for saving, carrying, and pulling out your data. Here you can store your data and important information for a short-term period or a long-term period. Here there are two types of storage devices which I have compared to. First one is primary storage device and the second one is secondary storage device. Here's the comparison I have given to you. In primary storage, you can store the data which is smaller in size. But in secondary storage device, you can store the data which are larger in size. And also in primary storage data, you can store the data for a temporary period. Whereas in secondary storage device, you can store the data for a long period of time. Its location is internally, and the secondary storage data is internal and external as well. Here are some examples I have given to you. RAM, known as a random access memory, and the second one is ROM, read only memory. RAM is a volatile memory. It is both readable and writable memory. You will lose your data if the power supply goes off. And the ROM is only readable memory. The data is never lost even the power supply goes off. And in your secondary storage devices, you have hard disk, compact disk, USB, floppy disk, etc. Now comes the representation of your data. All the information or data is stored in the form of zeros and ones. These symbols of zeros and ones are called binary digits or bits. A computer memory can consider as a group of cells. Each cell consists a bit of information as zero or one. A combination of bits is used to store data or instruction called bytes, nibbles, or words, depending on their number of bits they contain. A unit of storage represents the level of an electrical charge, can be either 0 or 1. It is known as a bit. And byte, another unit of storage that occupies 8 bits. Now the last part of your chapter is software. A software is a collection of instructions and code installed into computer but cannot be touched like hardware and are stored only in storage medium. First one in your software is system software. System software is a collection of program that supports the computer operations. It allows us to communicate with the computer. For example, operating system, MS Windows is the most commonly used operating systems. Now the next one is application software. Application software is a program which helps the user to perform specific tasks such as word processing, spreadsheets, graphics, desktop publishing, etc. For example, your Microsoft Office. That's all for today. Thank you.